comes the axe. Prove yourself.
To block, you side pull and you deny a lot of farm and get a lot of extra like experience advantage.
Makes sense.
So back in mid, Thompson and Sumail trading hits quite a bit here. Sumail.
That's a kill right there.
Oh, Fairy Fire. It's almost a kill. He's south as well.
That was
big camp isn't blocked. You side pull and you deny a lot of farm and get a lot of extra like experience advantage.
Makes sense. So
back in mid, Thompson and Sumail trading hits quite a bit here. Sumail.
That's a kill right there.
Oh, Fairy Fire. It's almost a kill. He's south as well.
That was really got here. Oh, arrow coming purge through.
Arrow. Oh, barely clips. S4 almost ran out of that one here. Now they've got the right click. Give it to Thompson. He's got the last hit on it. Thompson with the first blood mid. Same story as last game. And Enchantress with a few levels gets a bit trickier to deal with. Crit do return Carapace into an Impale. What a sick play from him. They kill Ana down bottom. They want No-Tell as well. And Crit's got plenty of regen here playing around with that he's playing around with and should be fine. Back at mid, Thompson though has got that
shrine, so it's like rather than just sitting in AFK in his lane, he does try to get stuff for himself sometimes or for help
coming up. Oh, they sidestep the arrow, nicely dodged. Jerk's gonna go down and that means Arteezy will get that bounty rune. As OG do get three though, you can see just how dominant of a laning stage they've had when they can get three bounty runes.
Little scary here. They maybe get a crit kill, but blown mana.
Oh,
yeah.
No-Tell gets the kill and may also get out of this one. He disarms the Enchantress with the level up. He's going for the deny. Not quite successful. Not enough duration on that Fate's Edict. With the rest of the jungle as well, Sumail's going to run right into this Venge stun. There's going to be a Fortune's End to follow it up most likely. Can they actually get this kill? They don't have the Monkey King, but I don't know if they need him. They purge off the Purifying Flames and they get the kill. The second one.
There it is. Thompson's in his zone, man.
Oh, he sees Fly. He does kind of reveal the fact there's a ward there here. I'm not sure if they'll... I mean, we'll be able to get this kill most likely with the Jingu and may pay for it with a D ward, but
all right, he's
back at bottom. They have gone in. Yeah, arrow crit kind of blocks it. Not sure if it was going to hit S4 or not, but he can say he saved his life there. As
well, they actually didn't deny the bot tower. Dire's top tower. A bit of a mistake there. Yeah. Must not have gone back. That's kind of a big loss.
They kind of forgot about it as bottom lane. Sumail. Oh my gosh, he doesn't even get a chance to ball on out. Double is possible to help his team find kills. Like, he probably should be telling his team, set up a gank for me and I will haunt and help secure them. Mid lane. Arteezy, though, is getting ganked himself. So
that was an illusion.
Oh, they see Fly TPing and.
All right.
That should be the death of the core Crystal Maiden. Boundless Strike is there. Thompson will finish him off. Sumail, though, coaches the
phase top, killing him is hard, and therefore killing the tier 1 tower is hard. And if they just.
Oracle brought down. But, yeah, putting S4 in these tricky lanes was working well. But then this Monkey King now has enough attack speed as also, well, as an Echo Saber to.
Sure.
No-Tell. Oh, is he going to be scouting these trees? Crit check one side. The Haunt, going to find him on the other. The Impale. Oh, he misses crit. Instead, though, it's Monkey King. They got the bigger kill. That's where Arteezy was really going. Thompson's streak has been ended by the storm. We've got ourselves a game. This is not over yet, say EG. You may have got this good early game start, but all it takes is a kill or two to punish that.